From the day you arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend than as my handmaiden. A dear friend, in fact.
Thank you, my lady.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain as if it were my own. What you've suffered is beyond imagining. And your poor family as well.
You're very kind, my lady.
Of course, Mira. But you must not despair. We will get through this together. You must understand there are limits to what I can say, especially here in King's Landing, now that I am to be queen. To have a handmaiden from the north whose family fought for Robb Stark, it raises questions at a time I can least afford. Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept. She mentioned the northern girl in my service, and she painted you a traitor. She was very pleased with herself.
What does she intend to do?
She intends to make you miserable, knowing that will make me miserable as well. She demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort, for what I don't know, but she's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her. I wouldn't ask this of you if it were not important. I cannot afford any conflict with Cersei with the wedding so near.
I'll do as you ask, my lady.
I knew I could trust you. Humor her. Tell her what she wants to hear.
Hätte ich jetzt schon...
See if the Queen Regent is ready to receive us.
Mein Anliegen vorbringen sollen, oder ist es jetzt zu spät? Ich werde mit ihr nochmal in Ruhe drüber reden können, was jetzt eigentlich hier mein Problem ist, oder? Scheiße.
You'll be fine. I know you will.
Ja, klar.
You may feel one thing, but you must say another.
Good luck.
Oh Gott, die wird mich jetzt so in die Ecke drängen, ey. Oh Mann, nie im Leben bin ich hier gewachsen. Aber ich werde mich an den Rat von Lady Marjorie halten. Einfach sagen, was wir es hören. Da, Tyrion, die Stimme der Vernunft.
Ah, Lady Marjorie, aren't you looking lovely this evening?
Lord Tyrion, Your Grace? With your permission, allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
Your Grace.
That's gefällt ihr.
The girl knows her courtesies. Impressive. You may rise.
House Forrester is a northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, Your Grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is.
Yes, Your Grace. To the one true king.
The one true king. Yet she didn't say... The girl is clever.
She only meant...
I don't care what she meant. I care what she said.
Okay, ja, ja. Scheiße.
I won't stand for impertinence from a girl of the
north. Schon in die Falle getappt.
If you would give her the chance to explain...
Perhaps she can explain why the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark for centuries. A house of traitors.
Yes, Your Grace. They are traitors.
The Starks were your liege lord, yet you name them traitors so easily. Is it any wonder you were so impertinent to ask which king deserves your loyalty, if you have any loyalty at all? Is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roose Bolton?
Yes, Your Grace. Absolutely.
I see. Despite the fact Roose Bolton allied with Walder Frey, If it was me, I'd find it difficult to so quickly forgive the men who killed my father. Old allegiances are not easily abandoned. But now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
Yes, Your Grace.
It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you? Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
Yes, Your Grace. I would do anything.
I see.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
It raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the rule? Our dear Margaery here was betrothed to Renly Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms. Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
I'm sure she regrets it.
Perhaps. Perhaps not.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
Echt mal.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the north, here in service to Lady Margaery. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question. And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure she would...
Let the girl answer the question.
I would be true to the king, Your Grace.
Well said. I was beginning to worry you didn't have your priorities straight.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's Landing.
Ah, Tyrion, eh?
My sense is this girl will say almost anything to get what she wants. Which is not very encouraging. I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Of course, Your Grace.
I'll walk you out. This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once, at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then, he didn't trust Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss. These would be trying times for your family, even under the best of circumstances.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion. That's very kind of you to say.
That certainly took courage. To so publicly declare your loyalty to Joffrey for all to hear. Poor Lady Margaery was humiliated, although Cersei seemed quite pleased. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining.
I was trying to appease her.
I think that was clear to everyone. My sister and I have our differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the Master of Coin who decides such matters. The Crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the Crown in this regard, not her.
What are you suggesting?
I suppose the Crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Margaery might not look favorably on such an alliance. And it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that? It may be far too dangerous.
I'm sorry, Lord Tyrion, but it's a risk I cannot afford.
I admire your discretion. Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight. Three beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival. The mere thought of them makes me thirsty already.
Thank you for the advice, Lord Tyrion.
Just be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
Ich glaube, das ist so suboptimal gelaufen. Da hätte man bestimmt irgendwie ein bisschen eleganter so nochmal rauskommen können. Aber eigentlich finde ich es ganz gut. Ich bin ja echt nur so eine kleine Handmaiden. Ich kann rhetorisch Cersei nicht das Wasser reichen. Ich finde es eigentlich ganz cool, dass sie mich echt so hart auflaufen lassen. Das passt schon.
Mira, I was worried. How was it? Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing. It's more than a little intimidating.
It didn't go very well.
I'm sorry. Cersei is known for being rather difficult. But at least it's over now. Lady Margaery has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back, here with the fourth cousins and the ninth-born sons. Ah, Sir Jaime, I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah?
What? It's true. And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper.
Ah, da sind sie wieder, diese Kopfschmerzen.
I'm told he has a paramour.
He is quite handsome.
And quite passionate, from what I've heard. Perhaps Lady Margaery could make the right introductions. Who knows, we might meet our future husbands. Although, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen? He does have a certain look about him, and he's always treated Lady Margaery well, which is more than you can say for his mother.
I'd marry anyone if it helped my family.
Right, of course.
Ist sie etwa eine Spionin?
Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden. Let's see, who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match. Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing? Well?
I'm sorry, my lady.
As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was pleased by your display, Mira. I'm just glad it's over.
Immerhin.
King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes. There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree?
It doesn't matter what you feel. It only matters what you say.
You learn very quickly. You were brave agreeing to obey the Boltons. That cannot have been easy. I know you must fear what Lord Bolton might do to your family. I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important. I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah. There are no secrets between us.
It's about my family.
I trust her.
I prefer to speak with you alone.
Go on. Ask.
Forgive me, my lady. I wouldn't otherwise ask this of you, but my mother insisted. It's about my family.
Ramsay Snow. What would you have me do?
My mother fears our family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. She thought, if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown. I know it's a lot to ask of you, and I wouldn't otherwise, but she insisted.
That
is no small request, especially now.
I know, my lady, and I wouldn't ask this of you otherwise. But my mother has left me no choice. She insisted.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks. And now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire? Joffrey will not look favorably on such a request.
It is that dire, my lady. I fear for my family's safety.
I don't know, Mira. If Cersei were to find out...
Don't let the Queen bully you. You have power over him, Lady Margaery, as no one else does. Not even his mother. Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
Very well. I'll make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady. I will send a raven to my family at once.
Ah, ich bin auch so ein alter Margaery-Flüsterer. Ob ich sie da wohl nicht in Teufelsküche bringe? Gerade noch so die Kurve gekriegt, ey. Mann. Ja, es war knapp. Aber ist ja dann vielleicht doch besser gelaufen, als das am Anfang so den Anschein hatte. Es hat wieder dunkel, Kerl. Sehr gut.
Seven Elves. Let's play a little game, shall we? Did you know my ancestors wore the skins of their enemies as a coat?
What's your name?
Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have fallen out of practice. But he didn't make it easy. What with all that bloody noise?
Okay. Like a drowning cat. I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets. But the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your father is the Warden of the North.
He does now. How much further is it to these foresters?
A day, my lord. Two at most.
What was that?
My lord?
Shh! Listen. There. Hear that? I know I heard something. Never mind. We've wasted enough time already.
Oh Mann, ey, huh. Bolt. Das wird jetzt kein schöner Anblick sein.
Bloody hell.
Ja, allerdings. Na gut, das kam jetzt nicht so wahnsinnig überraschend, was da sehen würde. Das war ja nun eigentlich klar.
Lord Ethan, as I was saying, you are young. And there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership. But 300 generations of Forrester Lords stand behind you. Lord Gerhard the Tall, who founded our house, and your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the river valley from the White Hills.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good. He was fair and wise and courageous in battle.
Why are you telling me this?
To help you rule, Lord Ethan. These were your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forrester Lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others. The Lord Sentinel. Forrester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
Keep walking, you craven son of a whore. Move! Summon the Lord! We need his judgment!
Oh, nein!
I've done nothing
wrong!
Oh,
so stressig noch zu sein.
I'm trying to survive!
Lord Ethan. Maester.
Who is this man?
This Craven is a deserter and a thief.
This house is doomed!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Two shields and three spears.
Is what Sir Roiland said true?
Yes, my lord. I fled. We should all flee.
It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right.
He speaks true.
I've a family to feed. And not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here. Where's our pay? Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone. Mercy. Go.
Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter. Most of us won't even live to see it.
We are in this together.
You say that, but it won't be you who's starving come winter.
You'll address him as Lord. Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it
is. Men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their lord will not permit
it. Verdammt, ihr beide recht.
We can send him to the war.
Show him mercy, my lord. He stole from us. Make him pay for what he stole. Give us justice.
Fuck him. I will decide.
Send him to the wall.
If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man. It will be an injustice, my lord.
Naja, so einfach ist er noch nicht.
My lord, my family depends on me.
I sentence you to the wall, where you will join the Night's Watch.
No, please, my lord! My family, without me, they'll die!
Tja, wenn hier jetzt jeder anfängt zu stehlen, dann kann ich den Laden echt dicht machen. Hätte ich mir jetzt drei Finger abhacken sollen.
That was certainly unpleasant, But a lord must meet our punishment when it's due. Not just yourself, of course.
Maester, what do you think?
Me?
Yes. Did I do what's right?
The wall seems like a fitting place for a thief. I only hope he doesn't find Garrett there and take his anger out on the poor squire. You heard what the thief said. I expect this sort of thing will happen again. But a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side. Someone you can rely on, no matter the circumstance. Possessing wisdom.
Who do you think I should choose?
There are two capable men for the role. They both want the job, but neither thinks very highly of the other.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here, the bracer of the Sentinel, the badge of office. Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen Sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house. Your Sentinel will wear this for all to see.
I'll make the right choice as Sentinel.
Come speak with me when you're ready to convene the small council, my lord.
Ach Gott, Entscheidung, Entscheidung, ey. Ja. Was? Nee, also mit ihm haben wir gerade gesprochen. Was haben wir zu essen denn da überhaupt? Wie geht's uns denn gerade so? Lecker Schweinchen.
Our provisions are rather low, my lord. I made the count again, just to be sure. But it doesn't look good.
Eric said people were going to starve. Why can't we feed them?
The war has taken its toll. Even our own stores for the house are dwindling. We couldn't withstand a siege, my lord. If the Boltons or the White Hills cut us off and wait us out, we'd only last a fortnight. But there are steps we can take. In the past, we've demanded food from the small folk to replenish our stores. We can do it again, if you'd like. We've done it before in desperate times. The last long winter, my family had to give all our pigs to the house.
No, there must be something else we can do.
Well, I hope we find it soon. We won't have much room to maneuver if we don't have the option of holding fast. I can speak to the huntsmen and trappers. Perhaps they can do more. My lord.
Ich weiß nicht, ob ich jetzt schon eine definitive Entscheidung treffen wollte, aber ich wollte jetzt auch nicht einfach mal so eben zusagen. Das ist das erste Mal, dass ich das höre. Oh, die wird auch nicht begeistert sein hier. Aber zu ihr komme ich auch gar nicht. Malcolm mittendrin.
Slash and parry. Ethan. Or should I say Lord Ethan?
Hello, Uncle Malcolm.
I saw what you did today. It's not an easy thing to do, showing mercy to a man who admits his guilt. But if you'll excuse me, my lord, I should finish packing before nightfall. I hope to be off tomorrow, at first light.
But where are you going?
Your mother asked me to cross the narrow sea to find your brother, Asher.
Asher?
She has asked me to return with him, to help the house.
She said nothing of this to me.
Because she fears you will not agree. I told her my place is here, that I'll be of no help to you in Essos. But she insisted.
Am Mittag.
I will hold, of course, until you've spoken with her about this. Just try to be kind to her. She's been living a nightmare made real. But you know that just as well.
She's my mother. I know how to speak to her.
I'm sure you do.
But my mother's fears are not the only ones I face. My people are scared as well. I'm told I must choose a sentinel.
If I may be so bold, Sir Roiland is the man for the job. He'd be a fine choice. And I'd trust him.
Why Sir Roiland?
We are at war. You need a warrior by your side. Roiland has the respect of his men and will bring strength and discipline to this house. Duncan would offer sage advice, but now is not the time to negotiate. Not with the likes of Ramsay Snow.
Thank you, Uncle.
Ethan, I need to talk to you.
Jetzt gibt's wieder eine Gardinenpredigt. Warum hast du sie nicht verschworen?
Mother told me, Mira has asked for Lady Marjorie's help.
Did she?
I knew we could rely on Mira. She always thinks of family above all else. Hopefully Lady Marjorie's influence will be enough. But right now I'm more concerned about you. I saw what you did to that man. I know you told me you'd have to change, but I suppose I hadn't believed you would.
I can't afford any more mistakes. Everyone knows what happened with Lord Whitehill. Garrod being sent to the wall without my knowledge.
I know. And that wasn't your fault.
But I'm the Lord. It's my responsibility. The people want me to lead. They need me to, but...
What? Ethan, please. Tell me.
Who should I name as my sentinel?
It should definitely be Duncan Tuttle.
Natürlich,
he's dependable and smart, and everyone trusts his judgment. Sir Roiland is unpredictable and likely to make matters worse.
You've always given me good advice. Thank you.
Es war so klar, dass wir jetzt zwei verschiedene Ratschläge von zwei verschiedenen Personen hören. Aber vielleicht sollte ich jetzt mal mit den Leuten selber reden, wenn wir da hinkommen. Ja, ne?
Sword up! Swing left! Parry! Wrong! I didn't know dogs had old swords.
A word?
Of course, my lord.
I have many decisions to make, and I wanted your advice. What's the state of our defenses? Are these men ready for what's coming?
This lot, ready? No, but they will be. We post anyone who can hold a spear along the parapet, up where they won't get much scrutiny, and put our meanest, nastiest-looking brutes front and center. That'll show Ramsay we're a force in our own right. You've got to project power, especially when you're weakened.
Thank you, Sir Roiland. I'll let you get back to training these men.
Thank you, my lord. And I'll be sure to watch out for more deserters. After today, I suspect there'll be more to come.
Moment mal.
Yes, my lord.
I need to name a sentinel.
Ah, you do. And it's good you came to
me.
I know this house, and everyone here knows me. They know I can hold the reins or wield the sword in equal measure. I'm the man you need. And might I remind you, it was Duncan Tuttle who sent Garrod to the wall. He undermined your authority and made you look weak to the White Hills. I would never do that to you. And if you pardon me saying so, I think your father would be proud.
Duncan Tuttle is a good man.
Aye, a fine man. Wise even. But he has no business being sentinel. He likes to talk. But now's the time for action. So, when will you declare your decision, my lord?
Tonight, at the small council meeting.
Very good. I trust your judgment, my lord.
Ja, nur so schnell schießen die Preußen nicht, ne? Also jetzt halt noch mal die Pferde still.
Do it like you mean it.
Kann ich mit ihm gar nicht reden? Bedauerlich.
Careful. Keep at it and you won't have much left. Something to pick your teeth with.
No, Ethan. Look at this. All good swords have a name. I call mine Two Brothers. I carve this to give me strength. And this, so I remember. I mean, I could never forget. But, oh, you know, don't you?
And what of your brother Asher? Where's his name?
There's only two sides to the blade. Besides... He left, so... Yeah. Someday, I'll have a real one. But not like that one. Only a lord could have that sword.
You'll have a good sword. I'm sure of it.
I watched you today. I saw what you did to that man. Was he our enemy? A bad man? Everyone keeps talking about them. enemies.
Rules mean nothing if we don't enforce them. It doesn't matter if he's good or bad. You can't steal. That's a rule.
Well, I say he was bad. Bad men killed Father and Roderick. They need someone to hurt them back. Even worse. I want a real sword. No one's afraid of wood. I'll find the men who took Roderick someday, and I'll make sure I have a real sword when I do.
Na, das kann alles heiler werden mit uns hier. Oh. So, aber Nathan Tower wollen wir noch nicht. Genau.
Duncan.
Yes, my lord.
I have much to consider and face a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can help. Your father often sought my counsel.
As Lord, I must name a sentinel.
Of course. And if I may ask, who do you favor for the role? Perhaps I can share my insight. And talking can sometimes help you make a decision.
Actually, I wanted to ask, why did you send Garrett away?
I did it for your own protection, my lord. Garrett had to go. By sending him away myself, I thought it would keep you blameless in the eyes of the White Hills. I only hope to give you an advantage, and I regret any action you disapprove of.
I understand, and you're forgiven.
Thank you, my lord.
Thank you, Duncan. I appreciate your advice.
I'm at your service, my lord.
Oh Mann, ey, ich bin immer noch nicht sicher.
You can't lift them, yeah?
Sollen wir jetzt nochmal in den Tower da gehen? Ah, man kann auch wirklich schneller laufen. Mit RT. Das ist ja mal was ganz Neues hier bei Telltale. Geil. Halt. Ach ja. Vielleicht hat er einen Ratschlag.
Meister?
Yes, Lord Ethan. I see you've spoken to a number of people. Are you prepared to name your sentinel?
What is it you're doing over here?
Admiring the ironwood, my lord. I studied it at the Citadel. The wood may be black, but I see gold. An entire forest of gold.
What do you mean?
It is our greatest asset, my lord. Why not give some of our ironwood to House Bolton and have them leave us be? We could ransom ourselves. You can hardly put a price on your own life, or the lives of those you love.
Ransom or a robbery? We may pay him now, but what's to stop him from coming back again?
Lord Ethan, the dangers of today outweigh the fears of tomorrow.
Ich weiß nicht, ob das so ein wahnsinnig durchdachter Vorschlag ist. Ich meine jetzt mal ganz unbescheiden, aber da habe ich schon recht. Hier von wegen kleiner Finger, ganze Hand und so. Ah, oh, das ist ja auch schön hier. Ja. Es ist ja alles recht überschaubar. Okay, können wir da runter. Ja gut, aber hilft alles nichts. Ich muss mich mal entscheiden.
My lord, are you now ready to name your sentinel?
Yes, Meister. I'm ready.
Very well. I will convene the small council at once.
Oh Gott, oh Gott, oh Gott. Und ich bin noch gar nicht entschieden, ey. Also eigentlich tendiere ich ja mehr hier zu, wie heißt er? Der Kollege mit dem Bart, mein Onkel. Ein besonderer, durchdachter Mann. Aber durchdacht und besonnen bin ich ja selber. Vielleicht wäre es gar nicht so schlecht, so jemand zu haben, der versucht, die Stärke durchzusetzen. Und ich probiere uns dann beide so auszubalancieren. Ich habe irgendwie nur das Gefühl, das Spiel manipuliert mich gerade so ein bisschen und es möchte, dass ich meinen Onkel wähle. Der ist jetzt irgendwie, habe ich das Gefühl, wird er eindeutig positiver gezeichnet. Und vielleicht wäre das schon ein Grund, sich genau anders zu entscheiden.
You may sit.
I believe Lord Ethan has reached his decision.
Before I name my sentinel, I must tell you. Duncan, Roiland, This house needs you both.
But you can only choose one, my lord.
Ja,
let him be on with it.
Many thought either of you would make a fine sentinel, but I have made my decision.
Och, jetzt gerade möchte ich es doch vielleicht eher danken geben. Er wirkt so machtgeil. Vielleicht ist das keine gute Idee. Das steigt ihm doch zu Kopfe. Ach Gott, was mache ich denn nur? Was mache ich denn? Scheiße.
Sir Roiland de Gore, you will be my sentinel.
Gods be praised. You've done well, Lord Ethan. You won't regret this.
A poor choice, my lord. Forgive me for saying so, but it's true.
Now, sentinel, what do you have to report of Ramsay Snow?
My scouts say he's a day's ride away. We've no time to waste. He'll arrive before any of our allies could be here.
Who knows what he's capable of? We need to prepare for the worst.
There's no need to panic. We can devise a plan to deal with him.
The Boltons need our people to harvest the ironwood. Even the bastard Ramsay must understand that.
He's not coming here to negotiate. We must answer with the sword.
That's bloody suicide. You gamble with the lives of everyone within these walls.
Quiet, Tuttle. You're not the
sentinel. So
I knew this would happen. He cannot be trusted.
This is the small council, is it not?
Let Duncan speak. I'd like to hear what he has to say. Duncan?
I'm sorry, Lord Ethan. You have chosen your sentinel. You should hear from him first.
The Bolton Sigil is a flayed man. Force is the only thing they understand.
Aber er
every man who can hold a spear or crossbow on the wall and make the bastard fill his boots with piss.
He would see it for the empty gesture that it is. And have us flayed. We must take a measured approach, my lord.
Gentlemen, please. Thank the gods Mira has asked Lady Marjorie for her help. It's not too late for the Crown to intervene on our behalf, but we must have a plan if Mira's efforts are not successful. I trust Mira's judgment. I don't doubt she did everything within her power to help us.
Mother. What do you recommend we do?
We must give him whatever he wants and be done with it.
Was?
It's too dangerous to do otherwise.
Okay, that's...
Why not make an offering for peace, my lord?
Yeah, the wisdom of the Citadel.
We can give the Boltons ironwood in exchange for their protection.
You must be mad. It's pure folly to just give away the only currency
yeah,
we have
that's
to buy.
Awesome.
Enough! Although Sir Roiland may object, I shall use diplomacy with Lord Snow. I would be foolish to pick a fight without negotiating first. I'll offer our allegiance and try to reach a reasonable agreement.
If you aren't ready for a fight, you're bound to lose when one breaks out.
Ethan has made his opinion known, and you will respect his decision.
Forgive us, my lord. We are, of course, here to serve you, as we served your father.
Aye.
Well then, let's decide how we shall set the stage for Ramsay's arrival. Invite him into this hall, and meet him face to face, lord to lord.
Ramsay Snow is no lord. That's absurd. You meet him at the gate with as much force as we can muster. Make him wait. Let him gaze upon Ironwrath. And when he enters, he'll know it's only because you allowed it.
Lord Ethan?
Okay, aber ich bin Lord und er ist nur ein Bastard. Ich muss einfach mal auch die Regeln...
I will meet him at the gate.
Die Regeln
durchsetzen. Very good, my lord. I shall prepare the men.
Men? We hardly have any. It's a foolish plan.
That's enough from you, Tuttle. Lord Ethan has spoken. Obey his command.
I've faithfully served this house for far too long to sit here and listen to this. Forgive me, my lord, but you are far too young to be the lord of this house. You're likely to get us all killed.
Sit down at once.
Apologies, my son. But now that it is settled, we know what we must do. You will meet Ramsay Snow at the gate, and we will not offer our ironwood.
No matter what, I will stand beside you, my lord, where your sentinel belongs.
Then perhaps we should adjourn. We have to prepare the house.
My lord, you have named your sentinel, but you still seem conflicted. And no matter what, you can't be indecisive. Not if you want to help this house. Forgive me.
There will always be those who question your leadership, which is why you need allies you can rely on. Family. Mira has done everything she can in King's Landing, but there are others who can help us. What about your brother, Asher?
Malcolm told me. You want to bring him back.
He's a skilled fighter. But what's more, he has the will to fight. A hunger for it. He always protected you and your sister. And we need all the help we can get.
But won't he be Lord if he returns? Do you want him to take my place?
Of course not. He has no interest in such things. And that's not what I want either. Asher is volatile. But that is his strength, too. Do you remember the Miller's boy? How he tormented you? I wanted to intervene, but your father said Ethan must fight his own battles. But when Asher saw it, he didn't take a breath. He grabbed the Miller's boy by the neck. That was his first instinct. Asher knocked out half the poor boy's teeth. Of course, your father was furious. But you were in danger, and there was nothing else Asher needed to know. Asher does not hesitate. He acts, and we need that. You have many fine qualities. But you do not have that anger inside you.
Asher is dangerous and unpredictable. His presence could help or hurt.
Having another sword at your side always helps, especially now. I'm trying to do what's best for this family, what this family needs. Ethan, let me send Malcolm to Essos.
I'm sorry, Mother, but I can't have Malcolm bring Asher back. He will not go to Essos. That is the final word. Do you hear me?
I hear you. But this is a mistake. I wish you trusted me with this. Know that you never stand alone. You are a forester. Mira stands with us, and she may be able to help us yet.
Ja, Mütter geben auch nicht immer die besten Ratschläge. Das haben wir nun wirklich bei den Starks gesehen. Man muss auch manchmal mit dem Fuß aufstampfen und sagen, nee, alle, so wie ich es sage, wird's gemacht. Schlüssel? Das ist bestimmt nicht gut, ey. Die weiß auch, dass der Schlüssel da lag. Was habe ich gemacht? So ein Mist, ey. Videospielinstinkt. Oh, Schlüssel, einschicken. Tyrell Family Seal. Nee, ich kann sich das Familiensiegel mitnehmen, jetzt mal ohne Scheiß, das weiß sie doch. Die wird doch danach suchen. Nee, nee, das lasse ich.
Ah,
ich hätte den Schlüssel wieder hinlegen sollen.
Oh. Lady Margaery is still with the king. I thought you might want to know. Thank you. I thought we were friends, Mira. When you dismissed me the other day, I won't say it didn't hurt my feelings.
We've known each other for years.
We are friends, Sarah. Truly.
Friends trust one another. They don't hold secrets. Now Lady Marjorie thinks you don't trust me. And she values your opinion very much.
Sarah, I...
My lady, I'll leave you to talk.
Are you all right, my lady?
The king was not inclined to offer help for your family. I'll need this mended.
Gods.
He said I was too easily swayed. And he reminded me that I am not yet his wife. I allayed his fear. For now. But it will be a long time before I can ask him for anything again. Nothing I said could cheer him. He wouldn't even speak to me when I left him.
What can I do to make this better, my lady?
There's nothing you can do, Mira.
Oh.
Understand, it was my mother's plan, not mine. I just hope you can find some way to forgive me.
This is simply not how things are done, Mira. Not in King's Landing.
I'm sorry, my lady.
Und das sah alles so gut aus.
Soon I will be queen. And maybe then I'll be in a better position to help you. But for now, we must both be cautious.
I must send a raven. I have to warn my family. If you'll excuse me, my lady.
Oh, ich warte nur auf den Moment, wo sie nach dem Schlüssel sucht, ey. Und dann beschuldigt sie wahrscheinlich entweder mich oder meine Freundin. Und natürlich war es meine Freundin, ganz klar. Werde ich ohne zu zögern ans Messer liefern. Hilft ja alles nichts. Oh, shit, ey.
M'lady.
Oh, es wird alles eine Katastrophe.
Begging your pardon, m'lady. I hope I didn't frighten you.
How long have you been waiting there?
Not long. I was just passing by when I saw you emerge from Lady Marjorie's room.
Er ist immer gerade irgendwie einfach nur dagegen.
I hope you saw. I was right before. About Lady Marjorie and Queen Cersei. I just want you to know, I can help you if you'd like. And your family, if you're willing to trust me. I hear all sorts of things. Things that could be useful for you.
How can you help me? My problems can't be solved by what you might overhear.
Which is why you must trust me, m'lady. You need allies. Hopefully I've proven I can be useful to you.
I'm sorry. I really must go.
Please don't despair. I know people who... People who'd be willing to help you.
Gerade wo es spannend wurde, ey. Ich bin jetzt ein bisschen geneigt, ihm wirklich zu vertrauen. Aber wie lang geht denn diese Episode, ey? Ist sie länger als die Walking Dead-Dinger? Oder kommt es nur so vor? Jo, mir soll es recht sein. Oh Gott, oh Gott, oh Gott, alles wird furchtbar.
Where the bloody hell is Duncan?
I've made a huge mistake.
Now fuck him if he's angry. I'm without King's Landing. I know you'd hoped Mira could help us, but I'm confident we've enough strength of our own. Your men are ready to act if needed.
Sir Roiland, I trust you'll keep a level head.
Of course, my lord. But the bastard of Bolton can't be trusted to do the same.
Bolton men approaching, my lord!
Thank you.
Something wrong with your gait? Well, aren't you the little lord? No wonder you can't open the gate. Shall we help you? Now let me in. This is a lovely pile of timber, isn't it?
You're welcome inside, but your men are not.
Did you hear that, men? The lord of the house says, fuck off. I think he's afraid of you. Wait here. For now.
Ach, den Dicken hätte ich aber auch gern draußen gelassen, ey.
A token for the new Warden of the North.
Let me guess. Forrester Iron.
Carved by our most skilled craftsman.
Ironwood. Doesn't look like much. Don't know what's so special about it.
Your father will appreciate it, I hope. Our ironwood is highly sought after.
My father is not so easily impressed. Not bad. Lord Whitehill, can your lot do this?
Given enough time, we could learn.
Given enough time, you could do a great many things. But not this, apparently. Quite the army you have, Lord Forrester. Very impressive.
Ja, aber vielleicht ist das doch echt gar nicht so schlecht. Ramsay hineinbitten, mit ihm reden. Der ist ja eh irre, der wird eh nicht zuhören. Aber zumindest habe ich jetzt nicht seine ganze verdammte Armee bei mir im Thronraum. Vielleicht ist das gar nicht so dumm. Möglicherweise kommen wir alle noch heil aus der Nummer raus. Möglicherweise. Ja, man kann doch mit dem auch nicht verhandeln, ey. Was soll er denn? Ja.
Look at that. More foresters.
Lord Ramsay.
Come out where I can see you.
Force him to focus on the business at hand.
What is it you want, Lord Ramsay?
What do I want? Everything. Nothing. We'll see. First, let's see you bend the knee to my father. Lord Bolton, Warden of the North. Words are wind. Anyone can say they're loyal. I want you to show me.
My lord.
Ha! That wasn't so hard now, was it? Here's the thing. I don't care about your loyalty. The Crown, however, wants what you've got. Whatever you've been supplying the Starks for centuries. Ships, shields, chamber pots. I expect you'll do the same for us. My father has promised as much to the King. You wouldn't want to make him a liar, would you? That wouldn't reflect well on me.
You needn't worry. Your father will have what he needs.
That's a good little lord.
You can't trust a forester.
They murdered our men.
It was a forester squire who did it. One Whitehill soldier dead. One Bolton. Yet your man lived.
He was within his right. They killed his family.
His right? He killed a loyal soldier in my father's army. You had me stand out in the wind and muck so you could show off your pathetic little army. That sort of insolence from one of our loyal bannermen will not do. So I've come up with a solution that will benefit everyone. The White Hills will be taking control of your Ironwood from this day forward.
What?
What? The Ironwood? But...
The White Hills are nothing more than up-jump thieves!
You can't do that!
Why not? You know something the White Hills don't? We are talking about trees. You grow them, you cut them down.
The foresters have been tending Ironwood for thousands of years. The White Hills had Ironwood, once, but now those hills are bare. Do you want Ironwood for the next 5 years, or the next 50 generations?
The little Lord does have a point. We'll try this. Lord Whitehill will take half of your Ironwood, and we'll see who fares better.
But my lord...
Half of something is better than the nothing you had before. To ensure there's no trouble, Lord Whitehill will install a garrison of 20 men within your walls.
At Ironwrath, that we cannot abide. Ethan...
They'll help maintain the king's peace. And make sure there's no more trouble.
Whitehill men? Never.
It's already done.
Wie sind die denn jetzt hier reinkommen?
You have a man you trust?
My son, Griff.
Griff will lead the garrison.
The seven hells he will.
Lads, do make this visit worthwhile.
Please, Sir Roiland, don't.
Look at this little forester. You're not frightened, are you?
Lord Ramsay, please.
And you? Are you Lord Ethan's older sister?
I'm his twin, my lord.
Oh, twins. Like the Queen and her brother. Well, hopefully not just like the Queen and her brother.
Schmierkopf.
I never had a sister. Always wanted one.
Enough, Lord Snow.
I have an idea. You'll come with me. You can be my highborn ward.
Lord Ramsay, that's enough.
Do you like hunting?
Let her go.
She's quite pretty. Your sister. I suppose you can stay. Aren't you the bold lord?
No! What have you done?
But I don't want a bold lord.
What?
Far too much trouble.
Ethan!
My lord!
No!
Even though you did bend the knee. I think we've come to an understanding.
Ethan!
I certainly feel better about all this.
Ethan!
No, however, the foresters need to keep their end of the bargain.
Stop!
Brian!
Take the boy as your ward.
No!
Kill him if they give you any trouble.
Brian!
Lovely meeting all of you. We'll have to do it again sometime.
Somebody help him!
Fetch the maester quickly!
You brought this on yourself.
Mama!
Stop!
Don't let take go! Me!
You will not take
Stop
him!
Stop! Help me! Ryan, please! Leave
no!
Me alone.
No! Ryan!
Do something!
Ethan? My son.
What?
Alter. Und ich gehe noch vor diesem Schmierkopf in die Knie, ey. Oh, fuck. Ja. That one backfired. Das ist ja alles mal schön in die Hose gegangen, ey. Shit.
Ethan sacrificed himself for us all. He saved Talia's life. He'll be remembered as Ethan the Brave.
This house needs a leader.
Lord Ethan named me Sentinel. I will lead this house.
My sister asked you to swear loyalty to her son, and you did it without flinching.
We can't let them hurt Ryan too. We have to stop them.
We do not stand alone. There are those who will fight for us. Those who hold House Forrester above all other loyalties.
Yeah!
Those who will not stop until Ethan is avenged. Until Ryan is home again, our house will not fall. We will be ready.
Nothing comes without a cost, my lady. Are you prepared for what might happen?
Ooh, Alter, geil. Okay, wahrscheinlich Entscheidungszeit jetzt. Okay, die Mehrheit, wie ich, hat Bauern zurückgelassen am Anfang. 73%, fast 74% haben Joffrey Loyalität geschworen. Nur 41% haben Eric zur Wall geschickt. Ja, knapp 40% haben Roiland, so wie ich, als Sentinel gewählt. Und doch immerhin noch 36,5% haben Ramsay Snow an den Toren empfangen, wie ich auch. Okay, also bin ich zweimal in der Mehrheit. Einmal davon sehr knapp und dreimal in der Minderheit. Ist ja vielleicht auch mal interessant. Ja. Okay, das war Episode 1. Iron from Ice. Und also nicht nur, weil es Game of Thrones ist und ich mich da sehr, sehr wohlfühle in diesem Universum. Mir gefällt es auch wirklich gut, weil es eindeutig ein ganz anderes Spielgefühl hat als The Walking Dead. Also hier hat man ja gesehen, gibt's relativ wenig Action-Sequenzen, wo einem das Herz bis zum Hals schlägt und man wahnsinnig schnell reagieren muss, sondern ich habe die ganze Zeit das Gefühl, dass wirklich jeder Schritt, den ich mache und unternehme, falsch sein kann. Die Schlinge zieht sich immer mehr zu, das Resultat haben wir gerade gesehen. Aber wie so oft bei Game of Thrones kann sich das Bad ja auch wenden. Also was jetzt ganz furchtbar und verzweifelt erscheint, ist dann vielleicht irgendwann doch der Weg zum Glück. Oder andersrum, auch das haben wir schon gesehen, was gut für mich aussieht, wendet sich dann ganz schnell und alles wird grauenvoll und es fließen Blut und Tränen. Das ist Game of Thrones. Also ich bin nicht unzufrieden mit meinem Spieldurchlauf. Ich bin sehr gespannt, wie es noch weitergeht. Das war Episode 1. Ich freue mich sehr fürs Zusehen. Diskutiert fleißig in den Kommentaren und seid auf jeden Fall auch beim nächsten Mal dabei, wenn Kim und danach ich Episode 2 des Game of Thrones Spiel von Telltale hier zocken werden. Bis dahin, Valar Morghulis.